Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, brothers and sisters. Today we want to talk about the husband who requests money from his wife, or even in some extreme cases, he demands it and says to her, I want you to give me your check, give me access to your bank account, make sure I know every ounce of spending you have. All of these things, he wants to have a full monitoring situation on her. What is her rights in a situation like this? What is her response with respect to this situation? These are the things that we want to highlight. So I've done some research on the topic, I've asked some questions, and there's a couple of things I want to share with you. So number one, the first point is, in Islam, this is a general usul al-fiqh principle. In Islam, the woman's wealth belongs solely to her. No one has any right to take that money or take that wealth from her. Everything that she works for is her responsibility, it's her property. Where are we getting this from? It's the verse in Surah An-Nisa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the men the caregivers or the breadwinners, or in Arabic, the qawwamun ala nisa. They are the ones that are in charge of the well-being and taking care of these women. So it's actually our responsibilities as husbands that we look after all of their bills, all of their payments, everything, every need that they have, we have to step up to the plate and we have to look after this. Now, of course, the level of need varies depending on what culture you live in and what society you come from. So maybe in one culture, the need for that culture is a house and a car. In another culture, it may just be the car, not necessarily a house, etc. So it varies. But the point is that the general rule is at least two-thirds of the income in that family has to be taken care of with the man. What is the last one-third is left with? It's usually left with her. She can take on this responsibility of providing for the family by choice, and she can do this if she sees her husband struggling. So he's living paycheck to paycheck. She's allowed to, at least by her own free will, get a job, and she should try to help, because at the end of the day, it is her husband and she is the wife. They just want to at least have that compatibility with each other. So that's the first thing. Here's the second point that I've jotted down here I want to share with you. It is ijma', a unanimous consensus among scholars, that the money belongs to her. So he can never wake up one day and claim it from her. He can never say, give me your bank account number, let me have access to your checks. He can never do this. Bil ijma', unanimously agreed amongst all scholars, the money does belong to her. The last point that I want you to consider, brothers and sisters, is what we briefly touched upon, and that is if his responsibilities is compromised in any way. So one day she decides, look, I'm bored, I don't have anything to do, I want to go get a job. If she goes and she gets a job, then this should be at least the minimum. In terms of her contribution, the minimum is she should try to help out. She might say, look, let me pay the internet bill and I'll help you out with that. This is providing she sees him struggling. This is out of her own consideration. And this goes back to the general sort of theme or the general feel of a marriage, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ مَوَدَّةً وَرَحْمَةً. He's placed mercy and love, or love and mercy, between the both of you. So you love him, then show mercy to the marriage as well and help each other out as best as you can. So I hope inshallah ta'ala this at least helps the situation for any one of you going through this. And I hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instills in our hearts that we respect each other's rights and we accept one another's rights. These rights, they come from Allah. We don't decide what's good or bad for one another. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already decided that for us. So once you have that attitude, your marriage will be filled with barakah bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. Jazakumullahu khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.